In this screencast, we're going to look at an example of adiabatic mixing. And the problem that we'll look at requires the use of an enthalpy concentration diagram to solve. So in this problem, we have 2 pounds of pure water at 100 degrees Fahrenheit, and it's mixed adiabatically with 1 pound of 60 weight percent H2SO4 solution, also at 100. We want to find the outlet temperature. So when we say that the process is adiabatic mixing, it implies that the mixing unit is well insulated and that there is no heat exchange with the surroundings. So Q is equal to 0. That means that any heat that's absorbed or released upon mixing is transferred to the final mixture. Now we know exactly what's going into the mixing unit. We do not know anything about the outlet. So we don't know the total mass, we don't know the concentration leaving the mixing unit. We can use mass balances to solve. We know that mass is conserved, and if we assume that there's no accumulation in the mixing unit, the mass balances will have the form of in is equal to out. We can quickly find out the total mass leaving the mixing unit by a total mass balance. The mass leaving the mixing unit is simply the sum of what goes in, which is 2 plus 1, so m out is equal to 3 pounds. To find the composition, we can use a balance on either H2SO4 or water. So I'll use a balance on H2SO4. So on the inlet side, the mass fraction of the H2SO4 solution going into the mixing unit is 0.6. And we multiply that by the total mass of that stream, which is 1 pound. And that must be equal to the mass fraction leaving the mixture, which is x, times the total mass, which we just calculated, is 3. So solving for x here, x is equal to 0.2. If we want to find the outlet temperature of the mixture, we're going to need an energy balance. Scrolling down here, I've redrawn the process flowchart with the variables that were just calculated. Next, we need an energy balance. So our energy balance in this case is Q is equal to delta H. For an adiabatic process, Q is equal to 0. So if our change in enthalpy is equal to 0, that implies that the inlet enthalpy has to be equal to the outlet enthalpy. The total enthalpy of each stream is dependent on how much material is associated with that stream. So we can rewrite the total enthalpy in terms of the specific enthalpy and the mass associated with each stream. So here I've labeled the specific enthalpy of each stream in the chart. Our energy balance changes as follows. On the inlet side, the enthalpy is the sum of the enthalpies of each stream, which can be written as 2 pounds times the specific enthalpy of stream 1, H1, plus 1 pound times the specific enthalpy of the second stream. And that has to be equal to 3 pounds times H3 on the outlet. On the inlet side, we know that both of these streams are at 100 degrees Fahrenheit. So we should be able to use an enthalpy concentration diagram to find the specific enthalpy of these solutions at a specific temperature and concentration. We don't know what the temperature is on the outlet side, but if we use the energy balance, we should be able to calculate H3. So we'll go to the enthalpy diagram to find values for H1 and H2. I've shown an example of the enthalpy concentration diagram for H2SO4. So the diagram shows the specific enthalpy of the solution in units of BTUs per pound of solution, and that's a function of the mass fraction of H2SO4. The specific enthalpy of the solution is shown for several isotherms. So these curves each represent different temperatures. In our case, on the inlet side, both of the streams that are mixed are at a temperature of 100 degrees Fahrenheit. So we can use this diagram to find the specific enthalpy of pure water and our H2SO4 going into the mixture. Our first stream was pure water, so the mass fraction of H2SO4 then is equal to 0. And we're at 100 degrees on the inlet side. So all the way on the left, the mass fraction of H2SO4 is 0, and the isotherm is 100. So if we trace this up to x is equal to 0, we can get a reading for the specific enthalpy at that temperature. We can see that it's pretty close to 70, so I'll use a value of 68. And again, the units there of specific enthalpy in this case are BTUs per pound of solution. Our second solution was a 60% H2SO4 solution, also at 100 degrees. So we can follow the 100 degree isotherm to x is equal to 0.6 to find our specific enthalpy, which is about at this point here. So it's less than negative 100, so I'll use a value of negative 108. Going back to the energy balance that we set up, We now have values for both H1 and H2, which we can use to solve for the specific enthalpy of the mixture. Plugging in the values that we found from the enthalpy diagram, we can calculate the value for H3, which I find is 9.3 BTUs per pound. So we know the specific enthalpy of the mixture. We also know the concentration from the mass balance. We found that the concentration is 0.2. We can use the enthalpy concentration diagram to find at what temperature does an H2SO4 solution of 20 mass fraction equal 9.3 BTUs per pound. So let's go back to the enthalpy concentration diagram to find that temperature. We know the specific enthalpy of the mixture is 9.3 BTUs per pound. So that's right below this horizontal line on the enthalpy diagram. We also know the concentration of the mixture is 20%. So if we bring that up, we can find the isotherm that this mixture has a specific enthalpy of 9.3 BTUs per pound. It's in between 100 and 120 in this region. If we zoom in a little bit here, we see that it's barely underneath the 120 degree isotherm. So our outlet temperature is approximately equal to 118 degrees Fahrenheit. In this case, the mixing of pure water with H2SO4 is an exothermic mixing process. So energy is released when we're mixing these two streams, which has the effect of driving the temperature up from 100 degrees to 118 degrees Fahrenheit.